It's literally like 2:30. It's 2:22. 2:22. My hair look crazy. I don't care. I just finished packing, y'all. Like, I legit just finished packing. I think I was doing that for like 2 or 3 hours. Like, I'm not even. Like, I think 2.5 hours. Like, I hate packing.
Let's go ahead and head back into DC.
Choose your fighter. Fight.
Welcome to my channel. My name is Courtney, but I go by Young and Kinky here on YouTube. And if you is new here, welcome to family. Hey. Who's not new here? Welcome back. How was you doing? I done missed you. Hope you are still staying safe out here in these streets. Okay. Okay. And as you can tell by the title of today's vlog, we going to DC. We are in DC. Well, technically we're going to Falls Church, Virginia. But we going to DC. This is my first trip in a year. The last time I went out of town was last year when I went to Philly, Jersey area to go see Ari Lennox in concert. And that was last March, and it is March right now. So I am getting ready to go out of town. This is actually a celebration of me and my best friend. We celebrate our friend-a-versary. I made that up. But we celebrate our friend-a-versary every year. We've been best friends, I think, because this was supposed to be last year's celebration. I think we've been best friends for, let me count. What year is this? Hey Siri. So 15. We have been best friends. This year will make 15 freaking years. Can you believe it? She is the person that is closest to me. I love her so much. She has been there through me. Been there for me through thick and thin. I would die for this girl. I would jail for this girl. I would murder for this girl. Okay, this is toxic love. Okay, she literally feels like my freaking soulmate. Like, this girl is my other half. Like, she's closer to me than any family member and any friend that I have ever had. That is my best friend in the world. I'll pop a picture up on the screen of us. I will pop a picture up of us when we were a bit younger in high school, back in the flip phone days. But we are going to DC for our first friend-a-versary. We just started this tradition the year before last. We went to Maryland, went to Ocean City, Maryland, and then we were supposed to go last year because we like to celebrate it around September, October, because that's when we started being friends back in 2009. And so we decided to go to DC. We were gonna go back to Philly because we both loved Philly so much. Like, Philly was so dope, Jersey was so dope, really loved it out there. Keep that in mind. But this year we decided to go back to DC, and actually we've been to DC before. So we went for my 21st birthday. Insert another picture here. We went for my 21st birthday and we had a fucking ball. And we had so much fun on that trip. And that was my 21st birthday. I'm 29 right now. So it was that long ago that we went to DC. So we're going to be going to DC again this year. Sorry if my energy is a little low. I am so tired. I've been up all day running around because my flight is tomorrow. I am actually flying from Atlanta to DC. And I'm going to be up there by myself for a day or two. And then she's going to meet me Friday evening. She's going to drive up because she still lives in our hometown, Norfolk, Virginia. And it's only only a 3-hour drive for her. But the reason why I'm flying in a little bit early is because I am going to look at some apartments. As you all know, I have been living in Atlanta for about 4 years now. This year is going to be 4 years. I moved here in 2020, middle of the pandemic. And I just feel like I love Atlanta. Like, this is like a second. It's become home for me now. But I don't want to put myself in a box and be trapped there. Like, I never want to feel like I'm stuck somewhere. And I'm not. I ain't got no kids. I'm single. Hashtag 4B movement. Period. Look it up if you don't know. But I just feel like now is the time. Last year in my 20s, now is the time to make decisions as far as like, do I want to stay? Do I want to continue to like put some roots down here? Do I want to leave? Do I want to go somewhere else? And like, when I say the options are open, the options are completely open. So I'll tell you guys some of the places that I'm considering moving, and you can give me some advice, because obviously I don't know shit about these places. Like, I just, it's places that I've been and I'm like, okay, like, I like this, I can see myself living here. Obviously DC is one of them, and I chose DC because it's closer to home. I am from Norfolk, Virginia. 757, stand up. Woo, 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 woo.
Stop it, get some help.
I chose DC because it's closer to home and it's only a 2-3 hour drive, and my parents are getting up there in age, so I would like to be a little bit close to them just in case anything happens. But I'm not the type of person to base my life around that, you know what I'm saying? Like, it's just a nice perk. The other place that I'm considering is Philly, and I know, like, Philly, like Camden, Jersey area. And I know y'all gonna say it's so dangerous and want, baby, I live in Atlanta, okay? Yeah, it's pretty goddamn dangerous down here too. So it, you know, it don't matter where, I can move to the safest neighborhood in the world and still get shot when I walk in my front door. Oh, maybe that's just an American thing, I don't know. I could still die at any point, anywhere, anytime. When we went to Philly, like Jersey area, like when I say I really loved it, like I loved it so much. I was like, this is great. And we went in like March, so it was cold outside, but I'm like, I miss this. I miss the cold. Like, down here in Atlanta, it never gets cold. So them jackets I got back there, never warm. Not one time, because it didn't get cold enough. I don't want to live somewhere where it's warm year round. Like, I want to have a winter and a spring and a summer and a fall. Those are the only two places on my list right now. I feel like there are so many possibilities. Honestly, I really want to move out of the country. Just keep that between you and I really want to move out of the country. And some countries that I'm thinking of are Thailand, Portugal, Mexico, maybe Iceland. I don't know. The thing is, I've never been to those places before. These are just ideas. But of course, I have to visit them first. So those will all be vlogs. Definitely going to Thailand this year. Definitely going to Ireland this year. Just to visit and see, can I actually see myself living there? Because that's a culture shock. Like, that is going to be so different for me. The food, the language, the people, the weather. Like, everything is going to be different. I know I'm talking about DC and Philly, but who knows? Maybe I'll move to one of those places for a few years and then I'll move out of the country. That's honestly my plan. But who knows? I just might stay in Atlanta. I do like it down here. There's nothing wrong with Atlanta. I love it down here. 10 out of 10 would definitely recommend. But I want to experience something else. I want to, if you know, you know. If you're from America, because I know I got some viewers that don't live in the United States. If you're from here, you know every state is different. Texas is different from Georgia, it's different from New York, it's different from Cali, it's different from Utah, it's different from damn Tennessee. Everything is different and I want to experience it. That's where I am with that, and I just wanted you guys to be a part of this journey. So definitely subscribe so you can stay tuned and follow me on this journey and maybe give me some helpful advice along the way. That's enough of that talking. It is about probably 10:30. And my flight leaves tomorrow at 9, but they start boarding at 8:50. And so I'm the type of person, I gotta be at the airport 2 hours early, especially because it's spring break. I gotta go through TSA and everything. I don't like leaving it up to chance. So I want to get to the airport around like 7, so that gives me like about 2 hours to get through TSA, find some breakfast, sit down and eat. I don't like feeling rushed, especially in the airport. That anxiety, I don't fucking like it. So I have my packing list. We have our handy dandy packing list that I showed you guys whenever I went to Houston for my concert. So actually, that I'm a type A girly. So this is the Renaissance concert, and this is this concert. So just click on it, and this is the trip. So my flight, I don't know if I should be showing all that information. It don't matter. My departing flight, returning flight. It's me and my BFF. So cute. And then this is the itinerary that I set for myself. Then going back some more. Note here. Where is it? So I have my packing list. So because I'm staying for a week, I'm gonna be packing a lot more stuff. I did get some stuff off of like Amazon, some packing cubes and everything. Never used those before. But I think it is time for me to start packing. It's 10:30. Well, there are a couple of other things, because I also, not only do I have that entire thing, I also have this, which is a DC trip checklist for everything that's already in Notion. But
The Notion is just for like packing and my itinerary. This is for like my little to-do, and this is way longer than this, but I did a lot of stuff today. So I still need to budget my paycheck because I'm not finna go out of town and spend my rent money. I need to wash my hair tonight. I'm doing bad two knots. I am wearing my hair natural this trip because me and my best friend are going to do the awkward JCPenney photo shoot on Saturday. So I'm like really excited. I need to do my lashes. I need to set up my cat's automatic feeder. And I have some apartments that I want to tour in mind. I need to set those appointments, but I'll probably do that tomorrow while I'm waiting for the plane or while I'm about to get on the plane as well. Let's get started. Okay, this is what my closet floor is currently look like. I got all my outfits and all my shoes and everything. And I bought these packing cubes over there from Amazon, so I'm gonna see if those fit. This is what I'm wearing too. The airport, and then gotta get everything in my carry-on and my personal item. So wish me luck. It's literally like 2:30. It's 2:22. My hair look crazy. I don't care. I just finished packing, y'all. Like, I legit just finished packing. I think I was doing that for like 2 or 3 hours. Like, I'm not even, like, I think 2.5 hours. Like, I hate packing. Guess what? Still haven't washed my hair, and I was supposed to do my lashes tonight, but I don't foresee that shit happening. I mean, I'm gonna wash my hair and I'm gonna do bantu knots. That's not gonna take me no time, but I don't think I'm getting no sleep tonight. I'm kind of mad at myself for not doing this shit earlier, or even starting like yesterday or whatever. My alarm is gonna go off in about three hours and some change. My alarm gonna go off, so I don't think I'm gonna get any sleep. So I'm gonna be exhausted tomorrow. Gonna be knocking the fuck out on that flight. Hopefully I don't got no dumbass kid kicking my fucking seat again.
I mean, where the fuck should I really even start?
Hey y'all, so I made it to DC. Well, technically I'm still in Northern Virginia. I haven't driven into DC yet. It is so lovely to see so many Virginia license plates again. So I'm a little peckish and I've been craving movie theater popcorn. I love movie theater popcorn. It's a movie theater right here. So I'm gonna get some popcorn at the movie theater and then go get a tea. I need to decide what I wanna do. So it should be a little bit afternoon. It was about 12:30 and I just wanted a latte, a chai tea latte. I don't drink coffee because I am so tired. When I said I was not on that flight, I was hitting one of these. I probably was all on the girl next to me, like, I was not the fuck out. I was only like 2.5 hours or 1.5 hours, so, but I was not the fuck out. So I needed a latte, so I'm finna go get some caffeine. I need to decide what I want to do because I have to take this car back tomorrow by 3, which is fine, but it doesn't really give me a lot of time tomorrow morning. So I need to see if I can look at any apartments today while I have the time, since it's still so freaking early in the day. So hopefully I can go look at maybe 2 today and then do like 3 tomorrow. And then I need to go to the mall, and I need to go to like Walmart and get some little knickknacks or something like that. I still can't check into my hotel till 3, so that's why I'm finna get this popcorn, get this latte, and then just kind of decide what I want to do. Call around to some of the apartments. I didn't want to go today because I look freaking crazy. I finished my bantu knots. I don't even think I told y'all, like, because I was so tired at the airport. Like, oh, I didn't finish my hair until 5:15 in the morning. Like, that's when I finished doing a packing and doing my hair and everything. And my alarm was gonna go off at 5:45, so I was like, let me just get up. So I just got up, got dressed. I never went to sleep last night, so I'm still really tired. I feel like tonight I'm gonna be in the bed pretty early. But as much as I can do today, I want to get done today. But I'm gonna see if I can't find some apartments that I wanted to look at. It's really cute. It's a 2024 Hyundai Kona, I think is what it's called. It's real nice. You could tell it's like just a little basic one, but it's real nice. I ain't know how to start this bitch, but I just really want to get to this hotel and unpack because all of my stuff is like all everywhere. But anyway, so I'm gonna get these snacks real quick.
Is it gas or electric?
So make this part have like a master key first. Okay.
Sauce in a watch. I don't want to change because I'm good where I'm at. My tie, so I'm always good where I'm at. Where the junior. jazzy every day. Tell them what I got for my money in a couple figures, kill a star to let. She put a nigga, then she on to the next. Really living large, she ain't all with a rack. When you need to think it's small in the mall with a rack. Roll with us if you really wanna get it. Go get a half a million in a sprinter. Home in a bitch, you know a big cripple. I got the hook up, don't really know. Yeah, cripples, then you bring a DNA. It's a syndicated with the state. Yeah, nigga, just a nigga, stay case. Very young, motherfucker, chase man, kind of bounce. Got a gun on my allowance. So I gotta rebody. The nigga feeling like I gotta see and always got the drug coming like a tank when I'm retrying to get him out. Then I never talk about it. Homies, why I'm moving well for the loudest. Rich niggas in the middle being modest. The way I'm doing deals, never treated like a artist in the house. You can DM my account. My PM 6 figures and I'm counting. 9 figures with the gold till I hit the D. Niggas ain't driven, so bury mine with me.
Make that music.
Should I really even start? I got hoes that I'm keeping in the dark. I got my niggas cross the street living large. Thinking back to the fact that they dead, thought my raps on the facts, and they sat with the bars. I got 2 phones, 1 need a charge. Yeah, they twins, I can tell they ass apart. I got big packs coming on the way. I got big snacks coming out to save. Got Lil Max with me, he the way. It's a big gap between us and the king. In the next life, I'm gonna stay paid. When I die, put my money in the grave. When I die, put my money in the grave. Gotta put a couple niggas in the case. Really just let me get in a race. I really might just put this on my face.
How many of these units you have in the building are lofted units? Just one? This one? Cool. That's a pretty view. That's the stadium, right? And you said they have concerts there too? And it's baseball? Say they weren't.
Okay, guys. So, take this off. So, we just toured our first apartment in DC. Let me show anybody around. That was the worst apartment. Do you know the price? I want y'all to guess the price for that apartment. It was like $4,000. It wasn't no ice machine on the refrigerator. Did y'all see that damn toilet? I was like, oh, hell no. I know he motherfucking lying. Like, right now, it's like two something. And in the unit that we saw, that was the only one that they had. I'm thinking this is a model unit. I'm not living on a goddamn first floor with these big ass windows where I can just see inside my crib. Oh, no. On to the next.
So, this is the building.
And it looks pretty big. And like I said, I definitely wanted to tour like one or two buildings today. So we toured the first one. I didn't like it. And then I go in here and they say, oh, you got to make an appointment. The earliest we have is April 4th to show me a fucking unit. Like, I'm very much confused. And then the other man about the other apartment, he was saying, well, you know, it'd be in demand. And so if you want to hold it, you got to pay like, you know, a $500 fee. For that apartment where the fucking toilet handle was yellow. That toilet was old as shit. And you want $4,000 a month, give or take, for that unit. Plus $500 pet fee, $500 admin fee, $50 application fee. Like, these apartment complexes be charging out the ass. But speaking of fees and everything, I do want to go ahead and plug myself. I do have an ebook. It is called So You Want to Move. And I literally wrote it for situations just like this. People who are trying to move. Everything's all chaotic. So it helps keep you organized. It guides you through the 10 steps. It is a 10-step guide on how to move out for the first time or again. Even if you already had your own first apartment or, you know what I'm saying, like you going living with your parents to your own place or your parents to roommates or roommates to your own. Like, it helps you every step of the way. Like, it is a very good guide. And I actually am using it for this apartment search. So DC was never really like my top like place to live. It's just like I want to stay on the east coast, and I do want to be as close to my family as possible. But I ain't finna pay all that exorbitant amount. And again, I just feel like at the very least, you could have gave me like a virtual tour. Like, we don't have anything right now, but you know, April 4th, we'll be able to show you around. So you want me to come back? Today is the 28th. You want me to come back 29, 30, 31, 1, 2, 3. You want me to come back in a week to look at an apartment? No, absolutely not. So they're scratched off the list. Anyways, I'm like really, really, really tired. It's almost 4 o'clock. So I want to go ahead and head to the hotel so I can go ahead and check in and everything, get unpacked a little bit, get comfortable. And then I'm probably going to go back out and go to the mall tonight and Walmart. If I don't make it to the mall tonight, then I'll go to the mall first thing tomorrow morning. Because like I said, me and my best friend are taking pictures and I definitely have to get my outfit. We're just doing long sleeve white t-shirt and some jeans, but I am so like I'm exhausted. You know that feeling when you feel like you're running on fumes, like you're just so exhausted? That's how I feel. Like I told y'all, I did not go to sleep last night at all. I only got an hour and a half of sleep on the plane. I kept waking up because I told her I kept hitting one of these. Like I said, I know this girl think I'm crazy as hell the way I keep leaning like that. Anyways, yeah, I'm done with DC apartments. Like I'm gonna find like two or three more to go look at tomorrow morning, but I mean I'm not impressed. And I don't know, it's probably the neighborhood I am. I think I am on the south side, and so that might have something to do with it. But to be charged, did y'all see that first apartment and they wanted like $4,000? Absolutely not. So I gotta use the bathroom, so I'm finna head to the hotel room now. Okay, hey y'all. So hold on, fix my bonnet. Okay, so it's like 9:48, and after I went and looked at the apartment, I came to the hotel and I was knocked the fuck out. Like definitely not. Now I do want to show one little thing. I'm gonna show y'all like the full room tomorrow when it's better lighting in here, but this purchase right here was the best purchase ever. Anybody wants the link, just comment down below and I'll give it to you. But this thing right here, I'm not a germaphobe at all, but when it comes to putting my face on hotel pillows and blankets and stuff, that shit creeps me out. Because like, first of all, what the fuck is that? That's not mine. I haven't eaten a damn thing in this bed, so why the fuck is it red shit on the damn pillow? And I always bring like a travel blanket because I like to pull my covers all the way up, and I don't like these blankets touching my face. I barely like them touching my skin. I'm not saying that about the cleaning staff or no shit like that, but this is my first time purchasing this. It literally came in the mail a few days ago. It is perfect because not only is my hair protected, my skin is protected too. So, and it's just, it's called a pillow bonnet. So you just put it up there. So I'm gonna, and this is handmade. It's a black owned small business. So female black owned small business. And I think that you guys should check it out. But I definitely came back to the room. I was knocked the fuck out for like 3 hours. Like I was so tired. I'm still really tired, but I'm hungry, so I decided to go get some food. And the restaurant here in this hotel, A1. So I got this drink. I got a mule, you know, like a Moscow mule. And then I got this freaking pizza. Cause I was like, let me go see what they got downstairs in the little restaurant. They have a small menu. It is kind of small. Dang, I need some ranch. Look. Do you see this big? I'm thinking the pizza is gonna be like a little personal size pizza. Y'all, this pizza was $8. Now, again, I do work at a hotel chain, so these hotels are discounted for me, but also the food is discounted. So, but even at full price, this pizza was only $16. $16 for this pizza. Are you kidding me? So I'm finna eat. I was gonna go out and get some food, but with that discount and with this drink and everything, I'm fine. So I'm just gonna eat this food. I do want to go to the grocery store just to get some snacks, and they have breakfast here too, but I want to get like just some snacks and little, you know, knickknacks for the hotel room because my best friend will be here tomorrow. Netflix on my iPad. Got Teresa computer on the TV. Computer on the TV, but I'm gonna watch one on my iPad, and then I'm gonna go to Harris Teeter because that's the grocery store around here. Or I was thinking about going 7-Eleven. I miss 7-Eleven so much. 7-Eleven and Wawa are superior to any other grocery store, not grocery store, convenience store. Argue with your mama. Quick Trip is ass. I don't even know how I'm gonna eat this whole thing. Like, at most, I'm gonna have this shit left over. I'm gonna have to try and stuff it in the damn fridge. But anyways, let me eat.
I should get back in there and see Phil.
I just love Harris Teeter. I got a couple of groceries because I hate when I be out of town on vacation and I don't got nothing to drink. And then, you know, the little hotel, little store, the marketplaces and the stuff that be happening in the hotels, some shit's be expensive. So I went to Harris Teeter, just grabbed a couple of juices in case we want to get like something to drink, or, you know what I'm saying, just to have something to drink and a couple of like snacks and stuff because definitely planning on being zooted. I just wanted to come on here and tell y'all something really important and something that I would stand on 100%, something that I would die for. Like, honestly, this store right here, this store right motherfucking here, let me clear it up for you. That store right there, that store in Wawa, 7-Eleven and Wawa is superior to any grocery, I mean any convenience store that you have in your area. argue with your mama. Anyways, I just really wanted a Slurpee because there are no 7-Elevens in Atlanta. Very fucking unfortunately and tragically, there are only like fucking Quick Trips and Circle K's, and they suck. They suck. So I'm finna get a proper Slurpee. It is 10:40. I woke up at 12. The thing was, I was supposed to have a meeting today, but while the meeting was supposed to start at 8 o'clock, they didn't send me the link for the meeting until 8:14. So I had went like to bed. I woke up at 7. I was gonna go get some breakfast, but I was so tired I didn't go to bed until like 2 something last night. I couldn't fall asleep. I definitely unpacked. Let me show you guys the hotel room real quick. Because I know I forgot I didn't do that yesterday. So door, then you walk in. This is the closet. There's a little mirror. Check me out. Wait till I lose this. I'm gonna be thick. Oh, I did a bantu knot on my hair. I'm not crazy about my hair, but we're going with it. Microwave. I had pizza. Oh, y'all know I had pizza yesterday. Then we got the fridge. That's all I got from like Harris Teeter, some juices. Them grapes look real good. Some water and stuff. And then bathroom, pretty nice. Love the lighting in here. And then two beds. My best friend is going to stay here. She is going to be on the road later this evening. My bed, the desk and everything. Got my crap all out. See, I was ready for the meeting. I was ready. But you're not going to send me no damn link for no meeting at 8:14. And the meeting started at 8 o'clock. I think I'm just going to hop up knowing that I'm probably not even in town in school. But you know what? I digress. And a nice little view. Again, we are in Falls Church, Virginia. We're like right outside of D.C. But yeah, so... right now, it is, like I said, 10 something. So I have to return the rental car back to Enterprise at 3. And I need to go look at 2 or 3 more apartments. And then I need to, my arm hurt. Like, why my arm always be hurting? And then I need to go to the mall and Walmart. And I don't think I'm gonna have time to go to the mall and Walmart in this rental car. So I think I'm gonna turn this car in. And then I don't know if you guys heard of Turo. I'm just going to probably rent a car for a couple of hours on Turo. Because I don't want to feel rushed. I want to get everything that I need to get done. And I can't extend this rental car because it was for a day. And the man already gave me extra. It was actually supposed to be turned in at 12. But he gave me some extra time. So, yeah. I actually need to set a reminder to be on the way at 2 o'clock. But anyways, I'm hungry. I didn't eat anything for breakfast. So I think that after I go look at the apartments, hopefully I have time to grab lunch. I want to go to a nice vegan restaurant because I don't think I told you guys, I'm not eating meat right now. I have not eaten meat in 39 days. So I'm not going vegan, maybe vegetarian, definitely not vegan, maybe pescatarian. I don't know. I just wanted to do it as a personal challenge to myself. So yeah, I also need to go to a dispensary if I can find one, and the ABC store or whatever they call it here. Liquor store, package store. What do y'all call a liquor store in your area? Because I'm from VA, we call it the ABC store. I think it stands for alcohol beverage control. You can only get liquor at the ABC store, but down in Atlanta they call it a package store. You can get liquor only at a package store. You know, you can get wine and beer and stuff like that from the grocery stores, but liquor, it's called a package store. I remember when I first moved down there, I was like, they send a lot of fucking packages, because like, why they got a package store on every corner? Why do they call it a package store? I have no idea. I probably just get like some little mini. I don't want to get like a whole bottle because me nor her drink like that. Like a couple shots and we done. Not even a couple. One shot and I'd be done. That drink I had at the bar last night, I didn't even finish. I mean, I finished it later, but like I took a couple sips and was fucked up. Anyways, let's go ahead and head back into DC. Chile. windy today. I'm at apartment number 2. The first one I went to, they didn't have any availability and it says tap to start and I'm tapping. Or maybe it meant there. So I don't know. This is very confusing because let me try and find a different way. There was another apartment. It said 301. Let me see how far the walk is. Okay, so I'm about 2.5 seconds from giving up. Because like I said, I got to turn my car back in at 3. And it is 12 right now. And I'm hungry. I really am hungry. So we're going to go look and see if this apartment here has any availability. But the first place I went to, there was like, oh, we're booked up. You can come try again in an hour. The next place I went to, I was like, oh, we're all booked up for the day. We can't. I'll take some. I'll eat some dirt, and the fact that this point I'm just walking, but that I didn't like take the time out to have appointments, but like, and it's been like 4 years since I done applied for an apartment, but damn, when we came that serious, like, I don't really understand. So I guess because, oh, hold on, it's windy. Y'all probably couldn't hear me. Hold on.
So we don't have concierge. We indicate this property, so we don't, everything is like remote. Like everything is on my phone.
Okay.
Don't let your phone die. You're gonna be locked out.
Oh damn! I ain't got no key fob, no backup.
No, we don't have key fob, so we use just our phone lock. So like if my phone is dead, I have to turn it off. We just
use the key fob. Right. Well, that's convenient.
Yeah, it's convenient, but if your phone dies.
But make sure it's charged.
Yeah, SOL. So again, we are paperless people, so we don't have security, but we're not like monitoring, you know.
Okay. Right. Oh, nice.
If you deliver on the 8th floor, above or under, you won't feel like, yeah, it's like shot.
Okay. Is there like a limit on how long you can stay in the co-working spaces? And those are 24/7 too? Okay. Yes, every day. Yes. It just comes in clutch, everything. 2-day shipper.
Switched
over. This is nice.
Good to have me on your side. I ain't saying that you need me. I love it.
Six God talk, but I ain't trying to get preachy. No, no. Seeing how you did, homeboy, please take it easy. Homie. I don't wanna play no games. I was shocked, honey. I was in tears almost. And it has a white refrigerator. I was like, oh, oh, not a white refrigerator. Girl, please put your shoes on. Let's go find you a home, honey. Oh, Lord.
I need two bedrooms.
Yeah, a lot of clothes, a lot of stuff.
Yeah, that's me. I definitely live on the two bedrooms.
Okay.
Trips that you plan for the next whole week. Been too long for a nigga so cheap. Being flex OD, sex OD. You got it, girl, you got it. You got it, girl, you got it. Yeah. Pretty little thing, you got a bang and now you
I didn't even realize how expensive it was. Waiting
you to DM looking hardy. Talking while you come around and now they starting. Blue to keep the 17, no bodies. Staying low, but you know what the price is. They ain't never got you know it being modest. Popping shit, but only cause you know you're popping.
Yeah. You see if they have it, girl. You got it. Because I know you want to live in something
nice. Yeah. You got it, girl. You got it. Right.
Just try to look at
little baby in a bag in a Birkin. No, not a bag, but the work.
It does. I see why you like this one. It definitely does.
It makes it feel freaky.
Oh, wow. It don't feel that small.
It doesn't feel like
hot girl. You a little sweet. Sweet like pale and sweet like peach. Like that. I could tell you crazy. She kind of intrigued me. Seen it on a gram trying to see that shit in 3D.
I'm leaving Sunday. Yes, I did yesterday. I'm just trying to find something to do. I don't know. I'll be on TikTok. Things are doing decent.
Good to have me on your side. I ain't saying that you need me.
Things, I don't know. It don't matter. Like, I don't know. I don't know how to answer that question.
Well,
okay, y'all. So, it's hot.
I don't get these cars.
I need some more lip gloss.
Because I'm a bad bitch. Fuck the bitch. Bitch gets slick, I'll cut the bitch. I'm a bad bitch. Suck some dick.
My lashes look so cute while looking at it.
That shit is amazing.
It's not sticky. It's a perfect tent. So that last apartment, it was a hell and a no for me. So y'all hear her saying, like, you know, some apartments, I guess in DC, they have, like, I feel like it's kind of like, I'm not gonna say Section 8, but I guess it's like more affordable apartments. So I guess, I don't know. It's crazy to me. Like, instead of just charging less, you're gonna charge less if you make within a certain threshold. And the first apartment, I made too much. This last apartment, it was a range, and so I'm right in that range, guys. The range is like $62,000. That was like the threshold. That was like affordable housing. If you make $62,000, I'm pretty sure you can afford something that's a little bit, you know what I'm saying? Like, I don't know, because I make more than that, and I'm like, do I even qualify for the affordable housing? Like, a regular, like, that last apartment, I think she said that wasn't, like, the first two she showed us, like, you see how it didn't even fucking have updated appliances? It was white appliances. And it's nothing wrong with white, but they could at least be updated white. Like, those were old white. And that apartment was probably, like, $2,000 to $3,000. I don't know, remember the exact number. Like, pay that much money for an apartment and it's not even like fully renovated, fully updated, is insane to me. Now, I don't know if I'm just in, I think I'm in Navy Yards. I think that is the neighborhood that I'm in. Only toured apartments on the south side. So I'm not sure if like I'm paying for, it's windy as hell out here. A sign just flew by. I'm not sure if I'm paying for location or if this is just everything. I know DC is one of the most expensive places in the country, you know, to rent from, but I am not paying $3,000 for a little ass apartment like that. So I'm not gonna say DC is off the list, and it's not even what I'm looking for. I have a, what time is it? It's 12:42, and I have a appointment at 1 o'clock to go see one more apartment, and then that's it. I'm not looking at no more apartments. My apartment wish list, I want a loft. 2 bedrooms, 2 bathrooms, 2-story loft. That is like the bare minimum. And of course I want other things like an island, an open concept, super, you know, a lot of natural light and super tall ceilings. And like I can appreciate that last apartment she showed where she said the windows make it feel bigger, and it definitely did, but paying over $3,000 for that seems like so insane to me. Like I can't. And did you see the closet? It's not even a walk-in closet. The bath, I'm not doing that. Like, that was a very nice apartment, but DC is just, I don't know what to say. Like, it's so expensive, and for what I'm paying for, I feel like I'm not really getting a lot. Like, you're telling me that like affordable housing is supposed to be $3,000 a month? That's affordable? That's affordable for a 1-bedroom apartment? So I'm gonna look at one more apartment, and then the only other place I wanted to look at was Philly. And I mean, I don't know, maybe, you know, because I didn't really have a lot of time to like look at different apartments, because, and especially because a lot of people don't just take walk-in tours. Like, I'm like, look, just show me the building real quick, show me a little tour, let's get it over and done with. She was really nice. That girl was super nice, very 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 nice. But I'm not, as soon as I walked into that apartment and I seen that closet and I seen that white refrigerator, I was like, baby, because right now my rent is like $1,300 for the space that I guess 832 square feet. And my apartment complex, it's not like this luxury complex, but it's decent. It's not like a raggedy one either. Oh no, girl. Like I said, I'm in DC right now. I'm also gonna be looking into Philly, Jersey area, I guess like Camden. I know that's supposed to be the hood or whatever. Like, look, I don't know, okay? I only know where I've been to. And when I was in Jersey, I was in Camden and I really liked it. I was in like the Philly, like Camden area, like wherever that that river like breaks it up, and it's like the two cities meet, or the two states I guess meet. But I'm gonna look up there too. I'm gonna plan a trip for sometime in the next, you know, few months to go up there, because my lease is up in September, but I'm thinking that I'm probably going to extend my lease by 6 more months. But I also just want to have options in case I don't want to extend, in case I'm like really ready to go in September. So we will definitely see, because this ain't it. Like, again, I don't know, I'm pretty sure it's the area, and if I go a little bit outside of the city, but like I want to live somewhere where it's walkable. Like, I want to live in a walkable like neighborhood, meaning I can walk to the grocery store, I can walk to the car repair shop, I can walk to different restaurants, and it's stuff to do, and it's fun, but it's not like too like downtown-y. I don't know if you get what I mean when I say that. Like, I don't want to be somewhere like there's a park, or like a Nationals park, I think there's a baseball team here, so there's a park And the apartment that we toured yesterday, the loft, it was right across the street. So I'm like, on game days, that is going to be packed. Traffic is going to be bad. Like, the restaurants are going to be packed. Like, I don't want to live like that, but I want to live somewhere like downtown Decatur, like downtown Atlanta, downtown, you know, North Georgia Hills and stuff, Sandy Springs. Like, that's all Atlanta area, but like the downtown areas are nice. So a bitch might be staying in Atlanta. Because I like Atlanta. I love Atlanta. I haven't even really gotten to it, really explore all the different areas and things they have to offer. But I'm not paying no exorbitant amount. I don't care if I do got it. I'm not paying an exorbitant amount of rent just so for a cute little apartment. Actually, it's where I live my damn head. Four walls and the roof, okay? But I am ready to move into a luxury, like, unit. And I'm like, okay, like, the price I'm trying to spend is somewhere, I would say, I know I'm probably going to be, it's going to be around $3,000. So $3,000 is fine. You know, that's a big jump. That's, you know, more than twice what I pay now, but my income has gone up so I could afford it. And I'm not living above my means, but you know what I'm saying? I got my YouTube channel, my business, and those things are going to grow too. So I'm looking at apartments in anticipation of what my business will bring into me, what I know that they will bring in as far as income. And, yeah, $3,000, that ain't it. I mean, I saw this beautiful loft in Atlanta. It was the most beautiful loft I ever seen. It was like $4,500, which I know is a lie. I don't know if people say, I'm not gonna pay that. I mean, you know, I'll pay for a mortgage. I don't want a fucking house. I don't want a house. I lived in a house my entire life. One house. My parents still own that house. They owned it before I was born. They still own it now. Home ownership is not what you think it is. Like, a lot of people just be like, well, I would never pay that. I'm gonna just get a house. First off, you gotta qualify, dummy. You have to qualify for a mortgage. You have to get approved for said mortgage. You gotta get a good interest rate on said mortgage. I mean, you have to have pretty decent credit and income and stuff like that. Then you gotta look, you gotta search, you gotta get a real estate agent, maybe even a broker. Like, it's a lot that goes into. And then even when you surpass all of that, that's your house. Everything is on you, like the lawn care, the curb appeal, the upkeep of the house. Like, my parents, I watched my parents replace the roof twice, the water heater a few times, repave the driveway, and the house still needs major repairs. Those things cost tens of thousands of dollars. Versus, I'm in an apartment, whistle burst that can happen, they're gonna move me to a different unit. Like, it's gonna be on them. Plus, I have renter's insurance to cover any damage to my personal thing. So I just, home ownership is not for me right now. In the future, I do want to buy a condo, but I'm not there yet. I want to rent. Like, I want to rent and live in a luxury unit. And guess what? I'm living in Atlanta, and I'm able to pick up and go and move wherever I want to move. So if I want to go to DC or Jersey or Philly or Cali, or, you know what I'm saying, like, I can go where I want to go. When you have a house, you're kind of tied to the air. And I'm people going, well, just rent it out. And what if they burn your house down? What if you rent it out to some people and they never leave and they become squatters? It's too much to deal with, and I'm not interested in dealing with that shit right now. I am barely an adult, okay? I am barely grown. I am not finna go out and try and buy no house and be all, I'm okay. The house that, and then also, I'm not gonna settle. I know that motherfucker on TikTok said that we supposed to settle. I'm not selling for nothing. When I buy a house, it's gonna be a really nice house. Like, I wanna have an estate. Like, I wanna buy a plot of land, like a very large plot of land that's very private. I do not want neighbors, and I want to build that house from the ground up. That costs a lot of money. I'm not just going to settle for a house just to have a house when I can just rent. People love to say, oh, renting is a waste of money. How is it a waste of money, you dumb fuck? I need somewhere to live. You're going to get a return on your investment. And what if you live in a neighborhood and you got an HOA that charges you thousands of dollars for no reason, and now you didn't pay your HOA fees, so now they got your house? Or your personal property taxes went from $1,000 a year to $7,000 a year just because the city can. Just because the city can't raise your personal property taxes, they did. And now you can't afford it. And now they got your house. There are so many different ways to lose your home. It's not even funny. And I'm not interested in doing that dumb shit. I'm okay. So I'm going to rent until I feel like purchasing my condo or building my home. That is the end of that conversation. I'm only like 8 minutes away from the last location. So I'm going to go ahead and head back over there and take this tour. Then I think I want to go ahead and grab something to eat. And then we will be returning the rental car because I have to turn it in by 3. This tour should maybe take 30 minutes. Let us go take this next tour.
I'm going to go to the next one.
to 11. Yeah. What did this unit start at? I like this one better than the other one. Yeah, I like the layout too. I just wanted to show you guys a little setup. So I'm back in the hotel room, obviously, and I'm about to take a nap because I'm really tired. My best friend just hit the road, so she should be here in like three and a half hours. I think it's 6 o'clock right now, so she should be here by like 9:30. But this is the setup I got for her because, like I said, we're celebrating our friend-a-versary 14 years last year. This year is 15 years, but we didn't celebrate last year. We pushed it into this year, so this technically is our 14th friend-a-versary. So I just got her some stuff from Ulta, so some Estee Lauder, some Clinique. I put the receipt in there so she can return it if she wants to. Can I just say how I hate Ulta bags? They're so fucking flimsy and cheap, like, bitch, and plastic. Ew, get with the times. I think I showed you guys this already, and then I wrote her a card. I got her a slice of cake because her and I love sweets, and then I got her sunflowers because she said these were her favorite. So I'm gonna take a shower, wash this makeup off, and the way I was like, I'm gonna look like a fucking creep if this not. Hi. I was sitting there. I was like, why the fuck? For 2 seconds, I was like, he got a Jeep, right? Like, let me find a damn Jeep. I was like, I don't want no fucking Jeep.
I'm glad you didn't just walk up to somebody's Jeep.
Me neither.
Oh my God.
How was the drive?
Trip was long as fuck. It was good though.
That was 2 seconds.
Okay, get your ass here.
No, I'm okay. No, I'm all right. I'm all right. I'm okay. Hi.
I'm sick as hell. Always. There's nothing new.
Shit. I was like, let me choose something with meaning so we don't die.
Somebody wants some booty in
all life and feet. Oh, Lord.
Now, you know, we are too old.
Girl, I bought that alcohol. I said, who the fuck drinking all that? I don't know. We're going to try.
Oh, my goodness.
Open it. Open it.
Why is it always this? And I always be like, damn it. I forgot again. Every single time.
We keep forgetting our anniversary. I'm going to take it personal if it's 3 years in a row.
I've been looking for a face frame. Oh, look at this already.
Oh, sorry, I just woke up. I'm tired.
I love
you slut. Widows right to work.
I love the sock. Wait, was it a refrigerator magnet, right?
Mm-hmm.
Hide his body magnet.
Yeah.
What's that? What you mean? So you're out. What the fuck? That is so cute.
I will. Just in your car, but I will.
Thank you.
Half past 12.
I don't know what half past
4 to 12. It's 12:30. We are on the way to take our pictures at JCPenney. It's half past 12, as I just told to Shiloh.
Say half past 12. Say half past 12 one more time.
And it is your responsibility.
And not at all.
Ooh. Oh.
Are you still recording?
Like, what the fuck? Wasn't the lesbian?
Oh, Archie.
Charlotte never listens to me. Even though I'm always right. And later on, right. I will tell you guys how we actually met.
And it will be a lie.
Not around. And I do want to tell you better hope that that I die before your ass, because at your funeral, I'm going to get up there. And let me tell you about this day in 2009 September. During a fire drill. I'm going to finally be able to tell my piece. My truth.
Her lie.
I was like, you ain't been on a vlog in a minute.
I'm glad to know that this trend hasn't died yet.
No, not yet.
It was very popular over Christmas time, but after that, it kind
of
died.
Oh, you guys had a lot of people in here?
Say again.
You guys had a lot of people in here?
We haven't. Because there's just a picture of her just
falling.
Ground. Yeah. So that was fun. Both wearing jeans. You both have back pockets, correct?
Yeah.
Okay, cool. That's just buzzing my head. It's been a hot second since I've done these. Okay. Run each other on the sides.
Like
this? Yep, this way. And then you just can do it back hands and back pockets. And put your wrist in the middle. Touching. Yep, perfect. And that's it.
Smiling or smiling?
I would do straight. I think that's both y'all doing it.
Okay.
Perfect.
I'm like, I think about something serious.
Facing me and then you're on one each other's face.
Get it together.
Perfect. And then just relax the thumbs down. Perfect.
Be like, what the hell?
We're so good. That was about to y'all almost did a whole face.
y'all.
So we are all dressed and ready. So after we took our pictures, we got something to eat at the mall. And then we walked around the mall a little bit, did a little bit of shopping. And then we came back to the hotel, got in the pool, both did a couple laps around the pool. Then we got in the hot tub and soaked for a little bit. Came back, showered, chill. And now, where we going?
I gave our.
The gay bar in DC. So we are all dressed. Let's do some outfits. Period. Ow. Okay. Good morning. It's like noon. We're going to get breakfast at the Silver Diner. And then we're gonna be hitting the road. Got like a 12-hour drive and I'm doing it by myself.
Shut your lying ass up. It's like two.
Don't listen to her. It's not 2 hours. That shit like four.
It is.
And she's making me do it all by myself. It's okay. It's because I'm Big Daddy. I'm a chauffeur.
It's because her ass flew here. And I drove all by myself.
She drove like 45 minutes. She so she like exaggerated. Oh, now it's 5 hours. Anyways, we're at the Silver Diner. Hope the food is good. Okay. We made it to the diner. Sugar coffee. Her gross coffee is disgusting. Coffee is, and I hate it. I was hoping they had a chocolate latte.
Just hop to Starbucks and get a chocolate.
I done told you that I do not support Starbucks. I wouldn't get nothing from there if it was free. And Jesus said, I'm gonna be at Starbucks in it. I guess I'm going to hell because I'm not going in there. You go in there. Show our food. Got some potatoes with onion and pepper. This shit looks like cat shit, but it's a tempeh bacon, it's vegan bacon. And then apple pie, French toast, scrambled cheese, eggs, and veggie sausage. Yeah. All right.
No powdered sugar, okay? They lie. Yeah. Found the waffle, veggie sausage, scrambled egg cheese.
Great.
Time to try. Yeah. Just give it a
close card.
For that long
ass wait, it better be close. You
want
to try this? Oh my god, this shit looks gross. Yeah. It tastes actually not bad.
I'm good.
No, try it. You need to be able to say, I tried tempeh bacon.
I don't need to be able to say that.
Here, yeah, try this little piece. Eat it.
Uh-uh.
It's not a bad taste. The taste is not bad either.
No, pull it forward. They're like pulled it all the way back and then like off to the side. And I was like, no.
It is not. You are so extra. That's nasty. And you know it's nasty. Stop it.
It's not.
It
looks like you're hiding.
It's not terrible.
Right.
It's not right much.
And they're like, oh, it's not nasty. Like, that's not what it looks like. Out here.
Money, hold up, gotta cut a lot of orders, dollars, quarters, wrist, water, reach, water, bitch, on a, wanna, come on, hunters, hey, I'm a stunner, stunner, summer, been in, hunter, cook up, hey, Michael, hey, surf up, wait, have it. Sippin' acorn, reach, nigga on A1, baby, back in the A-con, baby, but a pecan, bringin' that on the refund, breakin' that back till I see the sun, I fuck the bitch on the dick, keep but get on her knee, she only call me for six, speedin' the bitch, I stick up my foot on the neck, finna put on the wrist, we used to drop it at X-con, from the strong, gotta keep you a gun, I'm not a regular, but that's strong, fuckin' hoe by the week every month, she want me stickin' it deep in her gun, let me know if you with it or what. Catch your body, I keep it on hush. You pussy gon' tell in a rush. Come to the spot and I'm feeling the splash. I'm fun with these niggas a dub. Money, hold up, gotta cut up, ladder, order, dollars, quarters, wrist, water, reach, water, your bitch, on a, gonna, wanna, come on.
Yes, like what is that? That treacherous smell.
Well, our time.
That's okay.
So take it back out. Me and my best friend's time is up. And I'm going to stay with my cousin until I go back to the airport. Look at this kitty. You can't stomp. She is such a little attention whore. That's not a bad thing, honey. Her name is Jazzy. Just met her yesterday. Look at her little thumbs. She has the little thumbs. Oh my gosh. Show the people your thumbs. Show the people your thumbs, girl. Courtney's so cute. She is so nice and so gentle. And she came from the shelter. So, you know. Stop showing the camera your butthole. I was cuddling her all night. Okay, so just parked the car. I'm so sleepy. My cousin gave me like an allergy bill, but I'm convinced. I think the elevator worked. But I saw something that didn't work. But me and my family are out to eat. I just dropped them off in front of the restaurant. I had to park the car. There was no parking. It does work. So right now I'm in downtown Norfolk. This is my hometown, my city. Where I'm from, Norfolk, Virginia. And we're gonna go to a restaurant called Hell's Kitchen. I've been here before. But I'm really tired. Like I said, my cousin gave me an allergy pill and it felt like I'm still sleepy. Like I still feel groggy. So we shall see. Let's find our way out of here. Right this way? I don't know. I don't even know how I got here. Look how pretty. See over there is not a kiss and it's like a really nice waterfront view over there. This is just downtown. See people talking shit about Virginia. It's not bad. It's definitely not bad, but I couldn't move back down there, but look. I'm not doing anything.
crazy, but it is about 3:30, about quarter to four. I just got home a few hours ago. I came home. I just had to clean the entire house. I had to unpack, clean. I'm gonna wash my hair. Everything is nice and sanitized because I had a pet sitter for the week that because I was gone for a whole week and I have never really been gone that long. So had somebody in my house and it wasn't as clean as I left it, unfortunately. So I had to clean the entire house. I'm just one of the people because I live by myself. I'm just like, my germs I'm used to, but like to have somebody else in my house, like in the neck germs and where they was, I had to clean the whole house. So now I am fin to wash my hair and chill for the rest of the day. I'll probably do some work, start editing this vlog a little bit later on tonight, but I need to sit the hell down and take a nap because I have been traveling. I have been up since 3:30 this morning and I'm a little tired. I do think my trip was successful. I did really enjoy going to DC. I enjoyed going home and seeing my parents. Honestly, a big part of the reason why I did go home was because my father was in the hospital, and that was a big part of the reason why I was looking in DC, because I'm from Norfolk, Virginia, and DC is like 3.5 hours away from that. So I was just really just thinking about moving closer to home. But I mean, I don't know, we'll see. Atlanta's only a 2-hour plane ride, you know what I'm saying? So I'm gonna hop on the plane, but to be able to drive in a pinch if you can't find a plane ticket is what I was going for. So we will be going to Philly next to look at some apartments. That's about 5-6 hours away, but it's still on the East Coast. Again, I'm looking at these different places because I'm open to moving. I've been in Atlanta for 4 years. I'm open to moving somewhere else. I do want to stay on the East Coast, but guys, for real, I like real life want to move out of the country, but I don't even have a passport. I just have an inkling that I just want to explore life. Like seeing my father in the hospital, seeing my mother, like my parents are aged. My parents are in their 70s. So my parents are, you know, and they've never left Norfolk, Virginia. Like my parents don't have passports. We barely went on vacations outside like the 757, like the area that we grew up in. Like we never left our area code. Like we barely went to Richmond, which is a separate area code, but it's not even that far. Like we never really went anywhere. And my mom, like I literally took my mom to dinner or lunch yesterday. She was like, wow, like look at all these places. Like I lived in Norfolk my whole life and I've never even been down here. That's almost 80 years that they've lived in Norfolk, Virginia and haven't even like explored all of it. And I just do not want it, I don't want to say end up like that, but I just do not want that to be my story as well. So I want to explore and I want to live and I want to travel. I do plan on getting my passport this year so I can go look at some different countries. I do want to at least visit 5 countries before I make a decision as to where I want to move, but Thailand is really high on that list, even though I've never even been there. But Thailand is really high up on that list. I guess we will definitely see. Let me know what you thought about the apartments that we went to go see. Which one you like, which one you didn't like. If you have any other recommendations, because I did only visit one area, one neighborhood. I was really on the south side of DC. I really wasn't up north or anything. But so if there's a place that I missed, if there's somewhere more affordable, like I'm open. I just do prefer somewhere near some body of water, some ocean, some lake, a pond, an estuary, a puddle, something. Give me some sort of water. I'm from the beach. I want to be by the beach. That's just kind of what it, that's why Thailand screams to me, because like it's literally a freaking, they have so many different like little islands and you know like peninsulas, stuff like that, surrounded by beautiful waters and stuff like that. So we will definitely see. This is definitely the beginning of this journey. Thank you all so much for watching this week's vlog. I hope it was entertaining. Please don't forget to smash that red subscribe button down below. Show your girl some love and follow me on social media at YoungandKinky, because let's be friends. Duh. Anyways, thank you all so much for watching and I will see you guys in the next vlogging vlog. Bye.